Hearty wishes and greetings to each and every one of you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I am here to give you few details of our congregation at Kanyakulam. Kanyakulam is located at the extreme southern end of India. I am giving you a screenshot of the map, Google map. The nearest international airport is at Trivandrum, which is under the state of Kerala. From Trivandrum International Airport, you can reach in 2 hours by car, which is around 69.6, precisely the distance between the international airport to our congregation at Kanyakulam. Kanyakulam is a green field with mountains and with a very pleasant living location. You could see a few pictures I am sharing here. Very green field, you know, it gives a charming, pleasant environment when we walk through. In May 2014, we went here at Kanyakulam for distributing tracts, but where we were opposed by the local residents. You know, they are all non-Christians. They were opposing us that we should not issue the tracts here in their location. But as it is written in Romans 15:21, they to whom he was not spoken of shall see, and they that have not heard shall understand. Based on this verse, we decided to focus this particular place, Kanyakulam, for our ministry. Today in 2021 July, the Google map shows this much of residents filled into that location. What we decided to apply a bank loan, we did that. We purchased a small piece of land, started constructing a building, managed to inaugurate the congregation building by April 2016 by God's grace. This was the place where we purchased, you know, the highlighted one. And then this is the constructed building at the time. On the first day of worship, on the Lord's Day, myself, my wife Sophia, and my son Benden Joel and my grandmother were present. We did not know any single person on that day. This is the photo of that particular day that I was speaking on that building. God heard our prayers. We started knocking each and every single door at Kanyakulam, and one by one started attending on the Lord's Day. We started conducting Bible studies at their homes. Eventually, they started accepting Christ and got baptized. Till date, we have more or less 40 regular attendants, in which 23 are in the body of Christ. You know, I am sharing you a few photographs of baptism was given. The baptistry was separately built just behind the church building. I am here to give you a few information about our ministry. The first one I would like to give you about the information about the question and answers ministry. To educate the attendees in truth and strengthen everyone, we started conducting question and answers sessions to clear all their doubts with scriptural references. On the spot we were giving. This has become very successful. You know, those new people, when they started attending the services, attending the Bible studies, they ask many questions. How is the salvation? Do we have to immerse completely, or can we not only just sprinkle our head, or like other we see on the TV? And so many other questions will usually they started asking. Rather, we answer simply by our own understanding. We used to ask them to open the Bible and we give the reference, so that there is no left or right. They will have to accept it, and they were doing it. They were accepting. After a few months, based on their request, we started a WhatsApp group for sharing all those answers. But happily to say, several others also started joining the group, because those who received the answers, they started forwarding those answers to many other their friends. So based on that, they started coming into our group and they got added into that group. Today, in 3 years, this Q&A biblical WhatsApp group has grown into 10 groups. You know, each group has got maximum 257 members can be added. Now each one group is filled, second group is added, like that now 10 groups are running so far. As on date, 10th group is around with 150 members. I'm sure this is not going to stop here. It is going to grow further. Many from various states and countries join daily to get their doubts clarified. So far, 1,108 questions are answered. I would like to take you to the next level. What we have done, we were asked by all these people to print the first 1,000 answers for their permanent references. You know, this the answer started serving them at various point. They started conducting their own Bible studies. They started to educate their friends and all. So these answers become so useful for them, and especially the references are there. So many preachers also found these answers are very effective. So they asked us to print it in a hard copy. Based on the available fund with us in the congregation, we decided to print 288 copies, and it was published. Why 288 copies? Because that is one quire of paper when you purchase. Based on the size of the book, we managed to get 288 copies in one lot. Each book contains 1,475 pages. Each page is printed either side, and the book weighs 900 grams weight. I took more care, extra care, that the book should not be heavy. I used a very lightweight pages, papers, and it's a high quality paper, so that the print should be useful to everyone, and it should stay long for them. 245 copies are issued so far. Due to limited copies available, we stopped issuing further. And I will share you a few sample pages. The first one is the Tamil printed. Tamil question, second one is English one. Mostly 99% of the article is in Tamil. Very few questions are in English. I will translate for you the first two questions, which is in Tamil. Question number 220, they were someone has asked, Jesus is a foreign God, why do we have to accept? Can you give us reference? Can you answer us, why do we have to accept? That is question number 220. And then 221 says that, can Christian imprint images and text on their body? Like, you know, the images can we imprint? That was an answer I have given. And number 106, which is in English, you can easily read and identify the questions. I have managed to get ISBN recognition for our book. This is ISBN, so that it's globally recognized and identified easily. These are the books when it got printed. I took a few snaps for your information. I'm sharing it here. Number 3, topical daily articles. On behalf of Kanyakulam congregation, daily edification articles are written and being posted to everyone. Daily articles are published both in Tamil and in English languages. All these articles are sent daily to mobiles and are being posted in our blog, kanyakulamcoc.wordpress.com. You can view it easily under the playlist. It is arrayed properly. Special requests were also received from visually challenged people. So we started publishing audio recordings in YouTube recently, from May 21 onwards. You can find all those from our YouTube channel, youtube.com/joelsilsvi. Screenshots of daily articles I am sharing you for information. This is from English, which was published on 24 July. Get the right life insurance. You know, life insurance, usually when people take, that guarantees your medical expenses for the body, not for the soul or spirit. So this is the article based on that. Take the right insurance, that is important, rather than you take care of your body. The same what is written in Tamil, I am sharing you the screenshot here. Then again, the fourth important thing which I need to share with you is the Bible study. We conduct Bible study on Fridays at our church building. This is also being streamed on Google Meet. Approximately 30 to 40 outsiders are attending regularly. All these classes are available in our YouTube channel. Many others are also regularly watching for their in-depth learning. As our building is equipped with overhead projector, thus the teaching is more effective. We use visual classes for educating them better. We don't just keep on preaching and giving them audio, but we use visual pictures, we elaborate them, we give them the reasons so that they understand and they grasp it effectively, so that they can grow easily. You know, number five, I would like to inform you that we conduct Bible study at houses. We conduct between Monday to Thursday at various houses in this particular locality. Many non-Christians are attending regularly. When you approach, when you go for outreach and ask them to come to the church building, they feel awkward. They don't come on Sundays. They feel like a different feeling is there. Whereas when you conduct Bible studies in their location at certain houses, it is easy for them to come and sit for the prayer. So that when they started listening to the scriptures, when they started listening to the Bible studies, then they started coming to the church building for the Lord's Day and the Bible studies as well. There we really, these Bible studies at houses gives us very effective in soul winning. The outreach is so effective in this region with this method. And number six, I would like to share here the preacher's training. We plan to train 4 bachelors. We don't want to take more inmates at this moment. We just wanted to pick very precisely selected 4 bachelors, age between 25 to 32 years, from the congregation for an intensive training to become an effective preacher. That would really give us a good going in the upcoming days. The course is planned for 6 months per batch. They will be taught and trained to prepare sermon. They will be taught and trained to preach effectively. They will be trained to effectively carry out the field ministry. They will be trained to answer any questions with relevant scriptures. That is our motto. A few snaps of our congregation I'm sharing. This is taken in one of the Lord's Day. Our elder was giving the sermon. And then number two, this is taken at one of the regular meetings. You know, it's not on the Lord's Day, the normal day meeting. And number three, this is also the same regular day meetings. And then kindly remember us in your prayers fervently. We invite you all join with us in this rough field. The harvest indeed is great, but the laborers are few, as we read it from Matthew chapter 9 and 37. Thank you all. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot for listening to my introduction. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you very much.